grandpa's tree. It was hungry for a plate of greens. I made my way down the banquet where I could see an open door. And overhead a sign made a painted pine at the Dixie drugstore. Peppers and roots are hanging from the rafters above. There were oils and sprays all on display for money, luck, and for love. I reached down to pick one up when a dog came around my arm. And before I could see just who it was, she said, "You don't want that." Last man to walk the thing out of here just up and disappeared. Found his wallet and his wingtip shoes near a tombstone down in Algiers. What you need, my traveling friend, is a place to wash your jeans. I wouldn't be the least surprised if you were hungry for a plate of greens. She beckoned me on up the stair, but she done made up her mind. Said, "Kick off your boots and take off your hat, leave your pride behind."
Ooh, jambalaya. Ooh, jambalaya. Ooh, jambalaya.
She was turning tricks and nothing quick, and the room was black as pitch. She had me backed up against the wall. I was fumbling for the switch. I could hear her crack the shutters as I felt a little draft. When she gave me a shove into the tub and said, "It's time to take you a bath." I lay there in my stocking feet. I was soaked from head to toe. At the same time, down on Rampart Street, I heard the trumpet blow. Started popping from an old tin cup, was sitting in the windowsill. The whole place smelled like matches and onions on the grill. I was catching cold and I told her so as I let out a little cough. She told me, "Since my pants were clean, why don't I just dry off?" I found myself a little tea towel wrapped around my waist. I was standing there half naked when notice we were face to face.
Ooh, jambalaya. Ooh, jambalaya.
But now I see in the picture, it's getting pretty strange. Stripped bare in her chamber, and I hadn't even asked her name. I started to inquire, she knocked me upside the head. My noggin fell on fire and she pulled me into bed. You needn't ask no questions of the things that don't concern you. If you aren't afraid of the fire, son, fire, it won't burn you. And she took me down to a secret place in the bayou of her blankets. She offered to share her bourbon. I thanked her, then I drank it. Through a small crack in the ceiling burst the Louisiana moon. It shone down on our bodies and we began to croon.
Like always,
we were howling through the night. And I swear there were a beating those conga drums outside. Was crazy, and she replied, "It's true." She finally introduced herself as the famous Mary Lou. I said, "Now come on, darling." She died a century ago. "Don't believe the paper," she said. "It simply isn't so." I shot back, "That's impossible. There ain't a ghost of a chance." But I wouldn't turn a pretty ghost down if she asked me up to dance. We laughed until the morning, but then my pants had drained. I picked up my hat and pulled on my boots and I gathered up my prey.
Ooh, jambalaya.
done stepped out, I didn't see her anywhere. And I set out to find her, I headed on downstairs. I got down to the bottom, I couldn't believe my eyes. Gone were all the bottles and the remedy supplies. I shouted out for Mary, I darted out the door. An old man on the wooden porch said, "What you in there for?" "Son, you got no business. The Hooters store's been closed long as I remember, a century I suppose. But mister, I just spent the night with a young girl named LaVue. He said the widow Paris down had a little life on you." I said, "You mean to tell me that was the Buddha wing?"